Hello everyone. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
I hope you've managed to keep warm these last few days. It has been chilly, hasn't it? Even I felt it. So it really must have been cold. Our daily readings are taking us through Matthew's Gospel at the moment. And today we have a reading which I find so encouraging and so full of meaning. We're still in chapter 13. Excuse me, and we hear Jesus telling two more parables, both very short ones. So listen to the good news proclaimed in Matthew's Gospel, chapter 13, reading verses 31 to 35.
Glory to Christ our Saviour.
Jesus told them another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a mustard seed, which a man took and planted in his field. Though it is the smallest of all your seeds, yet when it grows, it is the largest of garden plants and becomes a tree, so that the birds of the air come and perch in its branches. He told them still another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like yeast that a woman took and mixed into a large amount of flour until it worked all through the dough. This is the gospel of Christ.
Praise to Christ our Lord.
If you listened to Henry Naidu's sermon yesterday, you would have heard a very similar message to the one I'm going to give you today. From little comes much. He was speaking about the way a couple of loaves and fish fed a great crowd of people. How that shows that a little can become abundance when it is used in God's name. From less to more. Here, from the very smallest seed grows a big tree. From a small beginning, God's kingdom is spreading. Don't you find that encouraging? From the ministry of one man, Jesus, we now have the Christian faith spread throughout the world. That can give us enormous hope for the future. All the problems of the pandemic, compounded by the recent lawlessness in this country, might leave us feeling a bit shell-shocked, anxious, uneasy, or just plain feeling down. But when we listen to these words of Jesus, we realize that the tree hasn't stopped growing. God's kingdom is still spreading. God is still at work in the world. And he works through us. Each one of us may be just a small seed, but when we work for the Lord, his kingdom grows. The image of the tree is a powerful one. There is strength there. But I also love, too, the picture of the birds nesting in the tree. It speaks to me of the love of God, giving me a safe place to live. And the second parable has a similar message. Just a small amount of yeast has great effect. You don't see the yeast at work, but it is mysteriously and inevitably changing the dough. Slowly, all the flour was leavened. God is at work, slowly transforming the world. And we can look at it from another perspective. Both parables show also how God's kingdom grows in the life of each one of us. When we put our trust in Jesus, the Holy Spirit comes and lives inside us. Just like the mustard seed planted in the ground, just like the yeast in the flour. No one can see the Spirit from the outside, but he is at work in us, growing us and changing us, enlarging God's kingdom in us, making us more like Jesus. So don't let us despair or become pessimistic about what is going on in the world. God is at work. The tree is growing. The yeast is slowly working its way through the dough. And that is good news. God's kingdom is about growth, abundance, and life. So let us pray. Thank you, Lord, that we know that you are at work in the world, that you are at work in us, and that you are at work in the world through us. Through your Holy Spirit, may we become more Christ-like, and may our small contribution help to grow your kingdom as we show love and mercy to others. Through Jesus Christ's sake, amen. Let us pray the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We pray the prayer for Africa. God bless Africa, protect our women and children, transform our leaders, heal our communities, restore our dignity, and give us peace. For Jesus Christ's sake. Amen. And we pray the prayer for South Africa. Lord, grant us a vision for our land, a land of justice where none shall prey on others, a land of plenty where poverty shall cease to fester, a land of work where all can be employed, a land of openness where all are accepted as equal, a land of healing where hatred and racial prejudice exist no more, a land of peace which is free of violence. And bring this vision to fruition for Jesus Christ's sake. Amen. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you, all whom you love and for whom you pray, now and always. Amen. And so, go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Keep warm, everybody, and stay safe. Lots and lots of love. Goodbye.
shout your praise forevermore.